Okay, hey guys, it's Jeff Lafferty, and VBlog number 4, I guess. It's actually, what is it? It's Monday, and it's Memorial Day, so. Just looking, is the shadow on the piece when I'm painting? Maybe I should actually back that off, so it's not quite so intense. Anyway, I decided to paint up this Hulk piece. And I just finished my rough sketch kind of thing. I mean, this is my real kind of rough, just initial throw it down kind of thing, get it inside the box. And then now I'm detailing up everything and redrawing it, really. And so it's kind of like, you know, kind of a drag, because this is sort of going to be a little bit of a repeat from the video yesterday, because I'm kind of working on the same part, but I don't know, like I said yesterday, I only kind of have like a certain time when I can really record these videos and stuff. I kind of got to record them while Tristan and Tanya are at the park. So, because it's like I'm working in my studio, and if like Tristan hears me in my studio, then he'll want to come in. So I kind of have to be sort of quiet, even though I'm running my hairdryer and the airbrush a lot of times. But anyway, I just gotta record them now. But let's see. So I have once I kind of sketch it out, I usually, you know, this is the pencil I sketch them out with. There, it's actually a colored pencil, but it's a real hard one. It's like one of those erasable color pencils. It's called Color Erase, and so it's a lot more like a pencil, but it's not quite as smeary as graphite. I think that's kind of why I like using them. And then I got my black color pencil, and I got some black paint over there. Eventually, I'm going to paint in the blacks. And, you know, it's funny. It's like I said yesterday, the piece just isn't going to look that great right now, because it's like all I'm trying to do is just get the blacks painted so that I can spray airbrush where I need to. And I probably won't get quite to the spraying the airbrush part in this video, because that's probably like a good hour away right now. Because there's a lot of kind of complicated blacks on him, you know, because that's, if you look at the sketch. And here's the sketch from yesterday, actually. That's how it finished up. And I liked it last night when I went to bed, but then when I got up this morning, I took a look at it, I'm like, dang, that's pretty cool. And I just thought, I'm going to go ahead and paint that. I've been wanting to do, I don't know, just, I've been thinking about trying to do like a series of these smaller, first I was thinking to do a series of sketch cards that were all based on like the Avengers. So, you know, be like Captain America, Iron Man, Hulk, Thor, and I can't remember the girl's name for some reason. I'm just pulling a blank. And I just thought those would be really cool. But I was thinking, like, do some sketch cards just to kind of get back doing that and see, you know, because it's a good market to work in, you know. You can put sketch card on your auction, and it brings in a certain kind of client to the eBay auctions. But then I don't know if I'll quite maybe get to a series, maybe. I definitely want to do like a Thor card. I want to do Iron Man at some point. And Black Widow. I mean, it's like, yeah, I don't know. But I got up this morning, I didn't really have, you know, anything to do. I'm kind of waiting on a couple commissions, and then I ended up getting another one. So, I just thought, hey, this is a good time to get this piece done and out. And I'm going to shoot for 2 days on it. I'm pretty sure I can do that pretty easy on this size piece. It's like, it's going to be 4x8, and it's kind of match up. Like, I don't know, I like this kind of like movie screen kind of smaller size. They make nice prints, that kind of thing. So that's what I'm doing with this one. And right now I'm just kind of trying to get it drawn enough that I can see where the blacks go, and then once once I get to that point. I hope I didn't turn the camera on too early, because it's like, this is a part where I kind of have to think about like proportion and that kind of stuff. And I'm not quite as scribbly as I would be when I get out here. So, and I'm also, you know, it's kind of tough because I'm doing that same thing I did yesterday where I'm working off the two different pieces of reference. I got this piece of reference, which is kind of like the look, the piece, the way I want the piece to look at the end. And then I got over here, I got this lighter piece of reference, so I kind of actually see what's going on in like around his hand, because that other picture, it's really hard to see back there, into what's going on around his eye. So it kind of throws me for a loop when I'm sitting here looking at the lighter one, and then I switch back to the darker one, and I go, oh wait, I want all those shadows in there and stuff, you know. Because that's part of what's going to make this piece really go, is because of that dark kind of stuff around his face there. But anyway, like I said, it's Monday. This is a holiday. I really didn't have to go back to work today. I know you guys are probably all waiting to hear what I'm going to do. And I pretty much decided what I'm going to do, but I think I'll just wait and not say it, just because I don't want to think about it right now. You know what I mean? I just want to think about getting art out and what I'm doing, you know, making my money this week, and getting the prints out, which I've had print sales, which is really cool. My store is like, I mean, I'm breaking my, like, first rule. Like, I used to always have people email me kind of back, especially when I was doing sketch cards, like, really consistently, and people would go, you know, how do you sell your art? You know, because they could see I was selling on eBay and places like that and pumping out art, and it's like, how do you sell your art? How do you sell it on the net? And, you know, inevitably, I'd go to their site, and I think I've told this story a few times, but it's valuable. I'd go to their site, and, you know, there'd just be, like, there'd be no store. There'd be, if there was even anything, it'd be kind of a deal where they're like, hey, email me if you want to buy any of this stuff, you know. So it's just, like, it was just set up in a way that was so hard to buy anything from, you know. Sorry, I got distracted. Cinder came and, like, sat right next to me here. And, I don't know, she always wants a pet. She hears me talking, you know. She likes to sit out by the front door, like, this time of day. And just hang out. But then, like, she hears me talking. Now she's, like, pushing on the camera. But she hears me talking, and she comes trucking on in here. And, to see who I'm talking to. And, of course, I'm not talking to anybody. I'm talking to the camera, so. What was I talking about before that, though? I kind of, like, forgot. I can hear the helicopters outside. I live right next to the airport, so. It's like the Boulder airport, so it's a very small airport. It's not like, you know, DIA or something, but. You know, planes and stuff are always taking off here. I don't really mind it. They're not that loud. And, the airport's actually a little more loud today because it's Memorial Day, so that means it's the Boulder, which is this big, huge race that happens in Boulder and shuts the whole town down today. So, like, that's what's kind of going on. I think, like, the news helicopters. Now she's really crashing into the camera. Cinder. The news helicopters are out there flying around and stuff, you know. I remember when Obama came to Boulder. You know, the president, he came to Boulder to, like, talk at the college or something a while ago, and I was, like, driving home from work, and they made this big deal of saying how he was coming in through DIA, and he wasn't going to fly into Boulder and all this stuff, and I was, like, driving home, and there was the first thing I noticed was there was just cops everywhere, and they were, like, on every corner, the closer I got to my house. And then when I turned down like the road out front is called Airport Road, and I, when I turned down Airport Road, I saw like there's all these like almost like, I mean, out here we have XL. I don't know what you got where you live, but XL is like the electric company type trucks and stuff, public service trucks basically. And there was all these trucks, like, I don't know if they were actually XL trucks or just the kind of, you know, like the trucks you see working on the light poles and all that kind of stuff. All these guys, like, all over the place, like, they were working on, they had their trucks parked up on the grass, and, you know, on the side of the road and stuff, and I'm pulling in here, and I'm driving down the street, and then I like, look, they're all, like, looking, like, super hard at me, you know, just, like, giving me, like, this total stare-down kind of thing, and as I drive by, and I'm looking at them, and they're all, they all got their hard hats on and stuff, and then they're also, they all have guns. They're all wearing a gun, like, under their vests and stuff, and I'm sure they were all, like, Secret Service or something. I was like, dear Lord, and the whole time that day, once I got home, they had one of those big, huge black helicopters like you see, you know, in Iraq or something, the ones that, you know, with the two propellers on top and everything, circling, like, the airport and the trailer park where I live, just like all that whole time, just like that helicopter just circled us. It was really almost kind of creepy, you know, because you just think, I mean, I don't know who would think about, you know, trying to do something to the president or whatever, but holy shit, man, I think you're, you know, you try something like that, you were opening up a can of worms, because those guys looked serious. But anyway, it's like a side rant there. And anyway, the race is today, so everybody's out running. I'm in here working my butt off. And it's right where I want to be, though. I mean, I've been working super hard and just kind of locking myself in my studio, and I haven't really seen anybody, but it kind of occurs to me, though, like when I'm at work, you know, it's one of the things that was really, you know, kind of made me mad about work lately is just, you know, I go to work in the morning. Tristan, sometimes, I'm allowed to, he'll actually wake up right as I'm leaving. So I get to see him for, you know, 10 minutes or so. And then I don't see him all day, you know what I mean? And I get home at whatever, I get home at 4 or 5. And a lot of times, you know, he'd be having a nap or something, and then I'd see him right at dinner, and they go to bed, you know, and it's just like, dang, man, you don't get to even see your family, and like Tanya, for crying out loud, it's already hard, like, once you get kids, to just kind of, you know, talk to your spouse a little bit, you know, I mean, it's funny, it really, you know, it just takes your time, I mean, it's awesome, but it's also like, you know, you almost have to kind of like, schedule a time to just talk, you know, with her. And it's like, yeah, but, you know, I'm working all the time. It's like, I just, you know, seeing Tanya is just hardly at all. I can see how people grow apart, and even though we're fine, we're not growing apart, but I could see how that could happen when people have kids and stuff and work. And, I mean, shoot, Tanya doesn't work, so it's like, sorry, I'm just trying to think here. She doesn't even work, so, you know, if she was at work, too, and I don't know, you know, when I talked to Tanya about this whole quitting thing, I don't know, should I tell that story, just in case you just tuned in on this video, but, I guess I will. Like, what's going on is I haven't quit my job, but, I didn't go to work for all of last week, and now it's kind of like the next week, and I'm a house painter, so, you know, honestly, I could just walk straight back into work and go, hey, what's up, guys, you know, because that's just how construction is. There's so many flakes, it's like, you know, I could easily flake my way right back in, but, at any rate, I'm thinking about not going back tomorrow, and, I don't know. I decided to make these videos while I made the decision to just, I don't know, just so I could talk it out in my own head, you know? You know, I appreciate the people that are listening. I know I say that every time so far, but I really do. And I appreciate, like, kind of what people have said. And not all of it applies to me. But it's interesting, different perspectives, you know. I think a lot of the younger people, not that there's a lot, I mean, you know, it's 6 or 8 comments where people have chimed in about what I should do. A lot of them are kind of like, just, you know, go for it, and if it doesn't work, you know, then at least you'll know it doesn't work and stuff. And I agree with that. And but I think, too, like when you got kids and people dependent on you, it's harder to fail. You know what I mean? You don't want to fail so bad that you're homeless. You know what I mean? You don't want to fail because you don't want to put your family through that. So it's like, if I go, I want to be damn sure that it's going to work. And there's no way to be sure. That's what sucks. But, yeah, see what I mean? It's like when you draw, it's like, when I do this, I, even though I'm doing a lot of drawing, I'm just trying to still figure out the blacks, and I'm going to hit it with a little paint, but it doesn't look very good right at this point, you know. And sometimes that can stop you. I remember, like, back when I first started painting like this, it's like, you know, I do the drawing, and I do the black, and, you know, that would be a process, and then you kind of get to it, and you'd be like, ah, I don't know if this is working, and maybe I might start over or something. But what I've learned is, like, you change it at each stage, so there's never really a, I mean, me starting over is just a drag, you don't, I don't know, I try not to ever really do that anymore, and I also try to finish everything. I used to have a real problem about not finishing stuff, but anyway, back to what I was saying is, you know, like, as far as failing or something, and, I don't know, another guy, I mean, that was somebody else brought up the point. I should actually write some of these guys down so I could give a shout out to all the people that are kind of helping me right now, you know, with their advice and stuff. And the shares, I really appreciate those shares. I know David Geister is one of them that's been sharing my videos every day almost. And I know Peter Palmiotti shared a couple. He's a really good artist, and so is David. David is an awesome artist. I'm going to stick his website in the show notes. He does, like, historical art, so he'll do, like, battles and all that kind of stuff. And he also does, he does, I mean, he's, his site's kind of a weird site. It's like, because a lot of times he'll be dressed up in costume of, like, some Civil War guy or something. And I think he does, like, the, reenactments and stuff, so. But, I mean, he's a great artist, and, Peter Palmiotti, of course, he's the other Palmiotti. Now I can't remember the other Palmiotti's name. The one who does comics and is all famous. Jimmy Palmiotti. He's his brother, and that doesn't matter because he's, you know, an awesome artist in his own right. And he, I don't know where his site would be, but he's somewhere. I'll try to find a link for him, too. And another one, Eric Mueller, who's been a, you know, friend of mine for a long time online. And I, you know, just endless appreciation. He did this awesome painting. He's another great artist. I'll link his Facebook page or something. I don't know where his site is now, or where he's posting. I know he's got a site, but he seems to post in different places than his site. But he did an awesome, awesome painting of me last year, just as a gift to my wife. It was a painting of me and Tristan, and it's, like, incredible. It's out in the kitchen, or I'd show it to you. But I do, it is in one of my other videos, or it might be on my site. I'm not quite sure where that's at, so. But thanks, you guys. Thanks for sharing my stuff. There might be a couple more if I forgot you. Sorry about that. And, oh, Chris Mason is another one. And he's another freaking awesome artist. He's worked on Blue Water Entertainment covers for, like, the Adam West comic. I did a cover for those guys, too. And that might have been where we kind of met or something. So his teeth come like this. But he's, like, a real Batman nut, like the 60s TV show and just and all that kind of stuff. And I really appreciate that, Chris. Oh, and that was actually, I just totally got off track, but I was talking about selling and, like, me breaking my own rule about selling art and prints and stuff, and my rule is to, like, make it easy for customers to buy from you, and that's what I meant by that whole thing, is, like, people would email me, how do you make it as an artist and stuff, and then I go to their site, and there's just, like, no way to buy anything, you know. And my response all the time was like, well, you know, it's like, how is somebody going to buy something from you? They got to, like, email you and go through all that rigmarole. And it's like, you know, and then on top of that, you know, you're not anywhere where people are going to buy, like, you know, like an eBay or Etsy or any of that kind of stuff. It's like, before anything, you got to have that. That's what I was going to say, is, like, my store is, like, a lot of my store is down right now, and I've had a couple people go and just buy prints, and they're finding their way into, like, my old store. I have a store, Envy store, now, which I like. Those guys, I think that it's a pretty good store. And then I also have a eCreator store that still has my stuff, all my old prints in it. And, but I don't really have it. You know, it's just what's left from when I was switching over to the Store Envy store. But the Store Envy store just doesn't have that much stuff in it yet. And the eCreator store is still up. So these guys are, like, going into my site and somehow getting into the eCreator store and still buying stuff. Like, you know, I'm making it, like, so hard, and they're still, like, you know, doing it. So I really got to get off my butt and get my store back up. And, you know, I just let that kind of happen because most of the sales and stuff are happening on eBay, so I was kind of like, whatever. And, now it's kind of like, hey, I need that thing going, and you know, leaving money on the table by not having it going, but that's something I gotta work on. But I'm also drawing so much that I'm having a hard time, updating my site and all that kind of stuff, but I'm not complaining. Oh, and another thing I messed up, I guess I'll tell you, is this. This seems to be, like, everything I'm doing wrong. But I lost my domain name, which was totally stupid. I guess it expired, and I didn't realize it. And I went into my email, and there were all these emails from GoDaddy, which were going straight into the spam folder for some reason. Probably because I told it to do that or something, you know. So anyway, that's a real pain in the neck, because GoDaddy's, like, not very cool about that, and, like, once you lose a domain, it's a real bitch to get it back, and they want you to, you know, it's like, you can't just go in and go, oh, okay, I paid my bill late, here's my money, and let me have my domain back. What they do is they stick it in this, I don't know, this place where you gotta contact them. Yeah, let me take a drink here. Anyway, they stick it in this place where I don't know what it is. It's like you gotta buy it from them again. You know what I mean? Not just, like, buy it. And I think it's because they know you want it. Then, you know. And then it's like $20 or something to get into this thing. And then, you know, I remember I lost another one of my domains a while ago, something for a different project, and I went in there to see, like, if I could get it back at some point, and they wanted, like, you know, $80 for this dang thing, and then I had to still pay for, you know, the yearly cost. And so I'm sure that's what they got. They've got JeffLafferty.com locked up in the vault, and yeah, I suppose I should pay the $80 or whatever the heck they're gonna charge the hell out of me to get it back, but I actually don't think I'm going to. And the reason I bring this up is a couple people from YouTube are like, hey, I can't get to your site. It's like, you know, all these financial links and stuff, which is actually better than last time. Last time that I lost that other site, I went there, and there was, like, Viagra links all over it. So I was like, GoDaddy, you suck, you know. Anyway, not the site, but just the landing page, you know. So I don't know. I'll probably just go and just buy a new domain, like... whatever the cheapest one is, like jefflafferty.me or something. I don't know. I'll tell you guys what it is tomorrow if I make a video. So, because it's just, I don't know. I mean, I just don't have money to waste right now. And I also think that in reality, you know, if you look at what's happening on the web and stuff, I don't honestly think that, like, your site, or I've noticed with my site, is that important anymore, you know?
It seems like it's more important to have a... Well, I think it's most important to have a store first, depending on what you're doing. I mean, it's all dependent on what you're doing, but, like, in my situation,
where I'm selling cards and art and stuff like that, you need some place to kind of... I mean, that's what's nice about a site, is that's a place where people can go back to, they can find out about commissions and stuff like that, and see your other stuff. But I think in general, though, I mean, people don't hit my site like the way they used to. I used to have like 100 and so people coming to my site every single day. And now, I mean, it's been going up lately just because I've been blogging so much. But, I mean, it'll be like, you know, 15 people in a day or something. And, I don't know, it's just, it's not like... I think that,
I mean, like, my other thing is I think that, I mean, I post everywhere. So I post on Facebook, on Twitter, and I post on DeviantArt. And I notice that, like, so many of the people that buy my stuff come from those places. That I think that,
you know, in a way, those are just kind of replacing my site, you know. They're not, my site just isn't, like, where people find out about Jeff Lafferty anymore. I think they go and they want to, you know me on Facebook for whatever reason or whatever, follow me on Facebook. And then it's like when they want to buy something, they go to eBay, and when they want to buy a print, they go to my store. And when they want to talk to me, they talk to me on Facebook, or they message me on DA or things like that. I don't think a site is beyond just saying, like, you know, when you're meeting somebody in, like, face-to-face or something, you could say, you know, oh, you know, jefflafferty.com, but, I don't know. It's like, I heard somebody actually talking about that with, like, webcomics, too. They were like, you know, it's, like, nobody hits my site anymore. My ad revenue has just gone to nothing, but my comic is still popular, and it's because I'm, you know, I have it in, like, the Facebook feed. I, you know, have it. He has it all these other places, and people just don't click. They're like, their ecosystem is Facebook, so they're staying on Facebook, or they're, you know, like you're saying, like I was saying, DeviantArt. DeviantArt's another
big one for me, or used to be. And, you know, it's like when people are on DeviantArt, and I'm the same way. It's like I truck around DeviantArt looking at art. I don't usually click through looking for another site. I just, like, that's kind of a drag, because that's actually real kind of crooked and stuff. So this is all going to be black out here.
It's kind of funny. It's like when I look over at the screen, sometimes I'll catch the feed going in my computer, and it's like, it's almost like, you know, you're flipping a piece upside down and looking at it in the mirror. It looks so different on the computer that it's like, whoa, what's that, you know? You see, like, what's wrong with it immediately. What else am I talking about here? Let's see. But anyway, I'll try to get whatever I end up buying, I'll post tomorrow. I think I'm going to throw a little black in this just to kind of show you guys, because I might end up wrapping up here. What I'm talking about with the blacks. My paintbrush. Kind of go through one of these a week. This one's getting kind of shot, as you can see. Is this the one? This was actually my good one. That's too bad it kind of dried out.
But that's probably one of the reasons I go through them once a week, because I don't wash them and stuff. But they're actually these cheaper brushes, and I think they're made for watercolor and acrylic. This Winsor Newton. I usually, you know, like a zero or something
for the detail type work.
But yeah, I used to even ink with them, like when I was back doing comic book type stuff, and it kind of works. I mean, the thing is they wear out quick. Like the brush that, you know, most people ink with and stuff. I mean, a really nice brush is this Winsor Newton? The Series 7, basically sable brushes. That's what I'm talking about. Some of you guys might know what I mean. That's kind of like just the industry standard. I think it's like the brushes that, you know, Will Eisner and everybody was using back in the day, and some comic book artists still use them. But I mean, they never wear out, you know. They're like they're an incredible brush and just never wear out. These are like a synthetic hair or whatever you want to call it. And these just wear out. Like this one's already kind of going. I can't really paint super detailed. But the thing is that, like, especially at this point, you don't need a brush that can paint. I'd say the only time I really need a brush where I really can paint with it is just in that last stage of when I'm painting in whites and highlights and, the, you know, any kind of actual painting I'm doing on the piece. So, but it's not, I don't know, I've never have, I mean, I did have some of those Series 7 brushes a long time ago, but I just, you know, I don't, they're so expensive, and I just stopped paying for them, basically. But it's not a bad alternative, you know, if you just need, you know, if you just need a brush that's kind of close to that you can do a lot of stuff with, you can just buy one of these and use it for a week and then just throw it away or just keep it, you know. So a lot of my brushes, when they're get messed up, they're kind of like, I look at them like technique brushes. They kind of make a certain thing, and I'll, see, I like that, how that is right there. See, and he's already starting. This is what I mean by the passes. It's like, you know, you throw down the pencil, and I think this is one of the reasons that a lot of people's, or a lot of younger artists' work kind of look a little bit amateurish sometimes, is because, you know, they don't realize, it's like they try to draw it all in one shot. They don't realize that, like, you know, whatever they drew, they can kind of go back in and make it pop or drop it back or whatever with another pass kind of thing. You know, they kind of like pencil and they shade and shade and shade, and when they're done shading, they're like, okay, that's done, you know what I mean? And I wish I wouldn't have done that. I'm going to try to erase that out of there. You know, that didn't look good either, but whatever. I'll fix it later. Yeah, let's see. Paint this in here. And there's also kind of a... The reason I do the blacks first is so they don't mix. I think I mentioned that in the last video. And his hairline's up here. But, I think it was my art teacher back in high school actually told me that a long, long time ago. And she was like, don't use black to paint, because, once it mixes with the other colors, it can dull them out. And I really, you know, I probably took that overly literally, because, like, for years I would never use black at all. And, you know, like, my pieces had black in them. I would make black out of, like, red and blue, and it would make this kind of black color that would be kind of accepted as black, but it wasn't black, and that works. But later on, I kind of figured this out, where you paint the black in first and then kind of paint transparently over it, so you get that rich black color, which I love, and I think that it's kind of missing in some of my earlier work.
You know, never putting any black in. I actually like the black shadows. You know, I like the dark because I think it's a lot more like real. So there's this hairline. This kind of comes down. So I'm kind of not, even though I'm doing blacks, I'm just, you know, so I mean, I'm kind of almost doing the dry brush kind of thing, doing the tonal piece first, and then putting color on top. And, I don't know. I don't know, do I have anything else to talk about today? I sure do appreciate everybody's comments and stuff.
Thanks so much for that. Let me get my hairbrush real quick, or hair dryer.
Yeah, I really appreciate all the comments. I think that's just super cool. If you guys wanna, I don't know, if you're looking for a commission, email me or, you know, hit my site, jefflafferty.com. It's probably not gonna be com anymore, but if you search just Jeff Lafferty, or I'll put a link in the show notes. And there's like commission information there. And if you wanna buy some of my pieces, I have a ton up on eBay right now. I'm sure I'll put that link in the show notes too. And I just appreciate all the support, you know. Whether you're buying stuff or not, I just think it's super cool, and I hope that people are getting something out of these videos. Like I said, I guess tomorrow's like the day I gotta go back to work, so we'll see if I make a video tomorrow. Thanks guys. I appreciate it. You know, everything, and it's kind of been an eye-opener, honestly. I don't know, just, you know, when you bring something up like this, it kind of hits a nerve, I think, you know, or it hits home with people, maybe. And it's just interesting to see, like, the amount of kind of, not the amount of people, but just, yeah, because people, you know, they've been personal messaging me, and you know, commenting on the site and all this stuff. And also, you know, some people have even been like buying stuff, saying, hey, I want to help you out, you know what I mean? And even like this latest commission I just got, like a really cool commission, which I'll be working on later this week. I mean, you know, the guy even said, he's like, hey, well, I want to help you get a good start. And that's super cool. So I just kind of floored by that, really, and I really appreciate it. So thanks a lot, guys, and see ya.